There's a good one right there again. Is that crappie? Is it? Oh my goodness, look at this. Look at this, dude. Look at this. Oh my goodness me, huh? Look at that. Out here in the deep clumps. There's no rhyme or reason. I'm in different weed from 7 feet, 8 feet, 9, 10, 11, 12, and the weed's all over the place, clumps and stuff like that, but I want to find the most aggressive fish, so I keep moving the trolling motor. As soon as I start getting bit, slow down, work that little area, and then maybe stay in the same depth and look for activity, seeing bait fish, the loons and stuff, and start casting around the boat and see where those fish are, where the majority are, or where they're starting. So in the meantime, keep casting, working around, different depths. No rhyme or reason for a certain depth. I just keep fishing all the way around here. Looking for fish. Sooner or later, they're gonna show me where they are. Are they gonna come out of the deep water first, which means 10, 11, 12 feet? Or will that 6, 7, 8, 9, is that where they're gonna come out of? I tend to think about that 8 and 9. There's one right there. That's crappie. It is too. See it? Big one. Big crappie. Lay down on the float, dude. How about that? Let me show you this, too. Look how big they are. Look at that. So you want to eat that bait? Just finished saying, you're going to find some thicker weed on these edges. And you got to use them pliers. Because you know he laid it down. You want to eat that slab magnet. That's not a bad start, eh? For the size of him.
Perfect weather, you know? Little bit of wind, but it's early. It's supposed to calm right down this afternoon. And in Northern Ontario, the black crappie opportunities are limitless. You just gotta find different lakes, different areas that have crappie and just big bluegills and things, and just go there. Figure it out, man. Go to a nice lodge, stay someplace, go with your buddies, your best friends. Hey, take your wife, your girlfriend, and just enjoy the fantastic autumn weather. But we wanna catch some fish. So the crappies this afternoon, I'm gonna fish the good old way that, you know, everybody loves to fish crappies. And how's that? With a slip float, little bobber.
Come on, big crappie, where are you? That's a good crappie right there, dude. Yep, look at the size of him. Just finished saying, huh? Look at the size of him. That's what I'm talking about right there. Right there. Big, beautiful slab crappie. Eating slab magnitude. Okay. October slabs. I'd say that's nice. Look at that beautiful fish.
But I got it on that 6 pound test, okay? And I got it where I'm gonna set about 4 feet and I put it up to a bobber stop. At the money end, I have the little slab magnet right there. 1/8 ounce, little jig head. And I got it in that white with chartreuse. Very, very sharp hooks. And I'm gonna throw it on the B&M Sam Super Sensitive and Crappie Wizard. I have multiple rods rigged up, so I'm rigged and ready. Different colors.
Here's a good one. Oh yeah, big crappie, dude. Big crappie. Big slab. Look at that. Look at that. Okay. How about that? I'll show you what this bait is. You won't believe it. It's like way down. Look at that. Way down, downtown. Right at the top lip. That's a good eater right there, boys. That's a good eater right there. Go on in there, boy.
When I'm out there fishing on those weed lines, edges and things like that, I want to have a few rods and different poles ready. I'm going to rig up with the, maybe, let's say, the crappie magnet, the slab magnet, but we're looking for some bigger crappies. So that bigger profile, the little kicking tail, big fat shad body, and they're super, super soft. I spray on a little bit of scent, you know, and that's all we're going to do, and hopefully find some crappies on the deep weeds in October.
A little thick weed I'm in right there. Yep. Look at the thick back on him. That's what you want right there. You find that thick weed, boy. You know what's in it? Those single pole fish that you catch right there. That's those single pole fish right there. Wow, when they take it, they take it. They're like largemouth. When they take it, they take it. Oh, I'm gonna look for some big ones. We got a few little eaters now. Come on. That's not bad, throwing back 12-inch crappies, eh?
This is my crappie candy right here. This is what I love, all the colors and tastes, and you name it, boy, smorgasbord. But for this afternoon, I'm gonna throw that little snow white with the chartreuse tail. It's a favorite. Another one looks like lemon meringue. It's got a lot of light lime, a little bit of milky white kind of stuff, okay? This is fantastic when you get an aggressive bite. The bright orange, the chartreuse tail. You see my common theme, right? Chartreuse, chartreuse, chartreuse. I want them to see it, because the crappies see it, I will get them to bite.
Just lay it down. There it goes. Look, oh, there's a crappie. See that? You see that? Hit my float, dude. Hit my float. Look. Got him. Just a nice fish, man. Just a nice crappie. But he just finished hitting my float. Isn't that wild? Isn't that wild? We're gonna take some fish home, but he's a bit smaller than what we want right there. You say to yourself, wow. And here's what I'm gonna do. That spot right there had some fish. Turn my boat like this. I'm gonna put those power poles down, dude. 7.5 feet of water. There's fish right in front of us here. We're gonna fish this spot right in front here. See if we can catch a few more crappies.
Okay, here's another rod. I got that little Northland sliding slip float. And this one I got in a real like snow white. Snow white with a chartreuse little tail. And it's on the Crappie Wizard 7.6. This is a fantastic rod. I can make those long bomb casts because I'm going to be looking for fish, looking for activity. Until they really go on a bite, you know, I need to find where they maybe are. Thicker clumps of weeds, 7 feet, 9 feet, 8 feet. Just moving around, using the sonars. Garmin shows me the side view, see where the weeds start and begin. But I want to find the thickest clumps, throw that little slab magnet, and just shake it. Once in a while, just shaking it, provoking a bite. It's so important, especially with crappie fishing, not to just sit and wait for a bite. You know, we're not using live minnows and stuff. We're using little plastics. So I want to utilize that little tail kicking just to provoke a strike.
But hey, there's fish here. That last bite I had was good. It felt heavier. Oh yeah, another crappie, dude. Look. Smiling and catching. Smiling and catching. That's what we're doing, dudes. We're smiling and catching.
Working that little weed edge. Casting, 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 waiting, thinking, come on, man, come on. I've been fishing all afternoon, getting a few bluegills and stuff, some smaller crappie. Go. And I decide just to stick with the slab magnet. Just stick with it. The bright white with the chartreuse. What happens? My beautiful slip float is sitting like this. I'm twitching it. All of a sudden it just goes bloop, sideways. Sideways. What happens? Big, beautiful, fat slab.
You gotta stay on him. There's one right there. I felt that. Is that a big crappie? Is it? Oh my goodness. Look at these fish, dude. Look at this. Look at these fish. Seriously? Look at that, man. He couldn't have got it any closer to the edge. Look at that. Tell me that's not fun. Let's put him in the box, boys. Let's put him in the box. He's gonna make my family happy.
A third option on the SAM Super Sensitive again. Sliding slip float, little B&M Pro 100 reel, 6 pound test still. And this thing around this one has a little bit smaller 1/16th ounce jig head with the crappie magnet right there. Red with chartreuse, sharp hook, the little split tail. You shake that, bounce it back and forth.
So I keep popping it. Driving nuts to see it. Come on, crappie. Good crappie right there, dude. This is a huge crappie, dude. Look at this. Look at that.
goodness me. Hey, am I smiling? I'm smiling. Pole's down, I ain't moving. You dissect the spot. Worst thing you can do is just keep moving around and you actually find a little school of fish sitting in that weed. That's another eater right there, isn't it? That's an eater right there. Just put him in there. Let's just keep going back and forth, okay? Let's put this on auto. Let's keep casting. Let's see how many fish I can catch on consecutive casts right in front of the boat.
Okay, as for crappie magnets, here's my choices again. I like the red with chartreuse. I got some black with chartreuse right there. Obviously the snow white with chartreuse. Orange, same thing in the tail. That chartreuse will always be on one of my rods. The therapist, so I got some purple. You know, I just got some options. This is my candy case number two. Slab magnets are number one. Crappie magnets are number two. I'm looking for big black slabs. I got lots of colors, lots of options, lots of opportunity.
Come on, big one. Take it down, boy. Wow, I love it when they do that. Come on. You're sitting right inside that weed, eh? Whoa, dude. This is sick, dude. This is sick. Big gill. Look at the size of this gill. But after a crappie hit my float, look at the size of that bluegill. I know what you're saying. Why isn't he eating them? Is that a handful of gill? That's a handful plus right there. Wow. Let them go. Man, they are like little piranhas. Could be bluegills too. Come on. That was crappie right there. I just missed it. That was crappie. Oh my goodness, eh? How many crappie are there? See that? That's one right there. What do you think of that, huh? What do you think of that? Look at that. Look at that. What do you think of that, eh? Oh yeah, man. I think it's fun times in Wild Crappieville. Fun times in Wild Crappieville. Let's put them in a box and have a feed of crappie and fall. Fall feed of crappie.
Now we're getting it done. Isn't it incredible? You know, you're fishing on those areas and you're kind of second guessing yourself. Is there crappie here? But when they come out of those weeds, there's no second guessing. Everywhere you look, they're pushing up bait. The seagulls are on a flurry in different areas of deep clumps. I'm fishing 7, 8, 9 feet of water and just throwing around, twitch, twitch. But the key is those thicker clumps. As soon as I get close to those thicker clumps, I cast over it, bring the float closer to it, twitch, twitch, boom, down it goes.
Stay on that weed. I love when they hit the float. Look at that. That's a big one, dude. That's a big crappie. Look at this. I kid you not. Look at this.
Wow.
Think I can hide my excitement? Look inside his mouth. Look inside there. Think he wanted that? I'd say he wanted that, dudes. When you gotta get them pliers, and you gotta find that hook bend, and bend it back, turn it, just like that, you know you have found yourself one big, floppy, sloppy, crappie. Right there, Ontario's finest. Black and gold in the box. Go on.
So now I'm catching some decent fish. I'm getting some 10, 11, 12 inches and stuff. And I'm seeing a lot of bait fish being pushed up in 12, 13 feet. So I move off that real thick weed line to the deeper weed in 12, 13 feet, make those casts, and now I'm catching those bigger fish that maybe are suspending, pushing up the bait off the weed lines closer to deep water main lake basin.
Come on, crappie. Just seen one take the float. Yeah, right there again, eh? Big crappie too, look at this. Oh boy.
sitting out here, huh? Oh my goodness, look at this. This is what I come for right here. More than a handful of slab. Look at that. Right at twilight. Right at twilight, we're almost done. I pulled off about 8.5 feet of water. The sun is behind the clouds. I'm hopefully gonna catch a couple more that are hitting my float, then go in, enjoy my evening, and come back again tomorrow and catch some more. No, so far, underhand pitches around the boat where you just caught. I'll show you where they are. See, there's all weed out there too. You can see where the gulls are eating. Those are probably damaged bait fish hit by those crappies and floating up. Seagulls, no, go down to feed. Wow. There's a good one right there again. Is that crappie? Is it? Oh my goodness, look at this. Look at this, dude. Look at this. Oh my goodness me, huh? Look at that. Out here in the deep clumps, we is catching some big, beautiful Ontario big black crappie. Look where that slab magnet is. Yeah? Oh yeah. Them big ones sit out here. They're the ones that are pounding the bait out here that the gulls are knocking. I need to get the pliers. You know that's a good fish. And you gotta get them pliers and you got it right in the meat. Take it, just turn it, put it down. Look at that, man. What's wrong with that? That is a fantastic, beautiful example of Ontario crappie. Man, you talk about fun. An October evening, catching crappies with a little slip float, slab magnet. I didn't have to go to a jerk bait, didn't have to go to a little fin spin, you know, just stuck with the slab magnet. And man, oh man, it got me a feed of crappie. I think I kept 10 to take home just to enjoy with the family. Think about those big black crappies in October, in Ontario, or wherever you fish, because they want to bite. You just got to be there. You got to use the right baits, right presentation, stay on them, keep fishing. But remember, fish extreme, fish crappie. Wow, hey, look how those seagulls, look at them, look at that. Dude, that is like you see shark frenzy. Look, it's because, oh my God, is that crappie? It is too, dude, it's a crappie. Look, this is what we come for right here, out here in the deep weed. Look. Hey, you just gotta move around, boys. Have some fun. Look at that. He ate that, didn't he? Oh my goodness me. Just gotta pop it back. That's a good one.